Well, I think the most important developments in the last few years have to do with the possibility of identifying the cancers and the molecular signature of cancer, because we are able to do the sequencing of the DNA of tumors. We are able to tell exactly which are the mutations that lead to cancer, and some of those mutations drive the cancer. And if we can identify them and make medicines that will act on those specifically, then we have a way of stopping. The problem of cancer is that whichever way you treat it, it comes back. And what happens is that the cancer mutates, and by following the molecular signature, we can know why they are resistant and choose another medicine, which would be a second stage medicine, and so on and so forth. The molecular signatures of cancer is very, very important now for the treatment, and that has changed completely the way we approach the management of the disease. More and more, we will understand which are the sequence of mutations that the different cancers have, and the combinations of medicines that are most effective at every one of those stages. We will, of course, not only try small molecules that we make chemically to deal with the problem, but we will start doing more and more combinations of radiotherapy with small molecules, and also immunological treatment and small molecules. The most modern approach, and the one which is gaining a lot of interest because of the success, is the possibility of stimulating your own immunological system to fight the disease. It's not to give you a medicine to kill the cancer, but to stimulate your own body to destroy the cancer cells. And that is one of the avenues that we think is going to develop very strongly in the next few years. But one of the things that we are very excited is the possibility of working earlier and earlier and earlier in the disease. We would like to believe that over the next 10, 15 years, we will be able to identify the cancer in populations which are not ill, in the normal population, by taking a blood sample or taking a measurement. We will be able to know that the cancer might develop and start treatment very early. I told you that the success in cancer comes from preventing, where there are many opportunities of preventing, early detecting and treating at an early stage. And I think the whole of the work is going to tilt towards earlier and earlier stages of the disease, to prevent it, to identify it, and to treat it at the earliest possible time.